Hey everybody, it's Megan and welcome back to Storytime Saturday. So for today's Storytime Saturday, I'm going to tell you guys the story of our fur babies, specifically our cats. Now I have done the meeting my husband story, dating, engagement, wedding, journey to both babies, and now it is a story about how our animals came to be in our home, specifically the cats. If you don't know, I have two cats now, but I've had three cats, or Wayne and I have had three cats, and we have one dog. So I'm going to tell you guys the story of the three cats, and then I will tell you the story of our dog, because they were our first babies, and I think animals are a huge, important part of like a home and a family. If they are there, they are the children usually first, but they are our babies. So it is important to acknowledge them. They're not just in the background. We love them to pieces. So here is a story of how we had three cats and now we only have two. So when Wayne and I were dating, he lived by himself in a one bedroom apartment and he was allowed to have animals. So he mentioned that he would want a cat or something, because a dog would be a little bit more of a responsibility. A cat you can kind of leave with food in a cat box, and that was just easier. So he put that into my head and I just ran with it. I was at Petco, and it was just like a random day. I was at Petco, I was getting something I think for my mom, and I walked past the cats. And at Petco, it's a little bit different than like PetSmart. So it is, and if you aren't an American, you don't know what I'm talking about. It is a pet store where they sell like food and everything for the animals. And they also sell the animals. But the cats are rescue cats. And that is the only way that I wanted to like adopt any animal, was that way, instead of going to like a breeder or anything, especially for cats. Sorry if you heard that, my dog just barked. She knows we're talking about the cats and not her. So I was at Petco and there was a little, I went into the little cat area and I found our cat. She spoke to me right away. She was gorgeous and her name was Cheetah, which of course I changed because that was just not gonna work. So she ended up being Bella. We adopted her. She was amazing. She was the best cat that I have ever had. She loved everybody. She came to us at a year and a half, and she was a tabby cat, like the traditional, just normal tabby cat. She was gorgeous and she was a big girl. She was really big. And she had an ear infection. Like, she came to us with an ear infection, so felt really bad for her. We got that under control and she was just the best cat ever. Well, she is the one that we lost too early. She was about 6 years old when we came back from a trip. We were only gone for maybe 4 days. And we came back and she was acting different. We didn't know why. We took her to the vet. She was falling over. She was losing weight, but still eating and still drinking and still going to the bathroom. But she kept falling over, which to me made it seem like a neurological issue. And sure enough, it was. We did as much testing as we could without spending too crazy amounts of money. And she just got worse. It was just worse and worse. Nothing was working. And we didn't go to the right doctor. If you have a cat, I suggest going to a cat specific, like cat animal hospital, that's just for cats, because I love other vets, but they just don't do as well with cats. So she ended up having cancer all over her body. She had, we believe, brain cancer. I ended up having to be the one that put her down because she just was getting worse and worse and worse, and it was horrible seeing her go through all that. So when we put her down, the vet was able to feel throughout her entire body was just full of, we believe, cancer. It was tumors of some kind. It was masses all over her body. So that's why she was failing so quickly, and it was just best for her to put her down. Absolutely 100% the hardest thing I have ever done. I'd never want to do that again. I know I probably will, because I'm the only one who can handle that kind of stuff in my family, but it was just so hard. So we lost our sweet Bella girl way too soon, way, way, way too soon, but she is not suffering anymore. So that is the story of Bella. On to our second cat, which is Layla. She is a calico, and my stepdad is a fireman, and one day he called us up and said, we just rescued kittens from a roof. typical fireman thing. They rescued kittens. There were three of them. There was a orange one, a calico one, and a black one. Two boys and a girl. And nobody wanted her. They were able to get rid of the other two to random, like, people. Like, I think even at the grocery store. I mean, firemen with cats. Kittens. People are going to flock to that. So nobody wanted Layla. Nobody wanted this sweet little girl. So they pretty much put her onto me. I was like, okay, we'll give her a home. And then I had to call up my husband, my boyfriend at the time, be like, so you're getting another cat. And his apartment complex was not too happy about that. But she is the most lovey cat ever. As a kitten, she would like lay across our chest. She would just like give you kisses. She was the cutest little, she was so tiny, tiny, tiny thing, because we got her way too soon. She should not have been away from her mom. But she has been one of the least amount of drama. She did go through heat once, so my husband says that he couldn't stand it when she was doing that. But she hasn't really needed any medication. She had an ear infection once, and that was it. And she is going on like almost 9 years now, I think. All of my cats are kind of like back to back, so it's hard to remember how old they are. But she loves me. She wants me. She wants to be by me. She wants to be on top of me. She is the most lovey, and when I'm pregnant, she's even more lovey. So it's funny. There's pictures of her like sitting on my pregnant belly when I had Nolan in there, and she just loves me. She doesn't like anyone else. She's also the least graceful cat. You toss her, she's not gonna fall on her feet. She's gonna fall on her back. She is not graceful by any means. And she acts more like a dog to me than a cat. But she, yeah, she's my Layla girl. She just stays away from everyone. She is on the bed most of the time. And I absolutely love her. She is my baby. So then we come to our third and final cat. Her name is Ziva. And she is a black cat who we believe has Siamese in her because of the way that her face is shaped. It's shaped like a Siamese. She's tubby now, so it's kind of hard. You have to push all the skin back. But she is all completely black. There's no other color on her. And we rescued her in order to give Layla someone to play with because Bella was too old. Bella just acted like an old cat from the beginning. So she didn't want to play with Layla. Well, Layla needed someone to play with. So we got Ziva for her. And Ziva's not the first pick. She was kind of the second pick. She was this tiny little scrawny thing. And she ended up having the most problems out of every cat. She is the most dramatic. She is just crazy. She came to us. She gave us ringworm. That was the first one. She would yowl. The Siamese in her just makes her yowl. She still does it. She would just walk around like she's lost and yowling. She had to get all of her teeth removed except for the canine ones because she had tooth decay. And it took thousands of dollars to finally get to the point where she is now. Because doctors wouldn't tell us, we finally went to the cat hospital, and the cat hospital was able to tell us what was wrong with her. She got down to 7 pounds. She was practically on death's doorstep. She would be upstairs, back when we lived in our old house, she would be licking herself and you could smell her downstairs. She was rotting from the inside out. It was horrible. So once we finally got it all figured out, she now is probably over 12 pounds. She is chunky. And it turned her back into a kitten. It is so cute to see her go from almost dead to back to a kitten. And she's been awesome ever since. So all of her issues have stopped, but she still is the drama queen. She still walks around yelling all the time. She's the one. She only likes me. Once again, she only likes me, but that's how she's always been. She like imprinted on me from the very beginning. And she just has always wanted me. She is the one who will bite you. The typical cat. Like if you're just petting her and she's all nice and then all of a sudden she just attacks you. She is the one who will chase after things. She kicks the dog out of the dog's bed and takes over. And ever since Bella has been gone, she became the alpha cat. They don't take care of the cat boxes like they used to when Bella was around. They just do whatever they want. It's like mom's not around anymore. And it's kind of funny how that happened. So Ziva became the alpha cat and she's the big one. She is huge. and I see like little dogs and people are like, oh, cute little dog. I'm like, my cat could eat that dog. Like that, and she would. Like that is how she is. She's our crazy one. So there you guys go. That is the story of how we got our precious little kitty cats. I love them to pieces. They are a pain in the butt, but I absolutely love them and I miss my Bella girl so much. So next week will be the story of how we got our dog, how we rescued her, because that is a very drama-filled story. So make sure to look out for that next Saturday. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Hit that subscribe button, give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.